A very good morning, students. Welcome to grade 3 maths recorded class. Okay, so this is a substitute class for Moina ma'am's class. As she will not be able to take classes for 15 to 20 days, I will be substituting her class. But some of the classes is getting clashed for 3rd and 4th standard. So instead of certain some online classes, you will be sending a recorded video, because same time when you have max class, I have a grade 4 max class. So such cases a recorded video will be sent. Okay, so in today's recorded video, we are doing a problem exercise 12A, first problem under your chapter data handling pictograph. As discussed in the previous online class that was conducted by me itself, we had discussed what is pictograph, right? So many kids have given very beautiful, wonderful answers. That is, what is pictograph? Representing the given information in the form of a pictures, okay, which includes label, key, index, all those things, title, are called as the pictograph. Okay, so we will continue the same concept. So today I am going to explain you exercise 12A. Under that you have first one. So today's recorded video will be solving the first problem. Okay, yes, if you are able to see the board. Okay, yes. Okay, your first problem is there are 4 sections. Okay, so there are 4 sections: section A, section B, section C, section D. And in each section, these are the number of students. So what is the students strength of the students in section A? Okay, so section A's number of students are 36. 36 students study in section A. 39 students study in section B. In section C, 33 students. And in section D, it is 42 students. And they have asked you, can you find the highest number of students? Which section has highest number? Okay, which section has highest number? So which is the largest number over here? 42. So 42 is the more number. So highest number, the section D. So you have a question there. So section D has the highest strength of the students. Okay, and they've asked you which section has the lowest number of the students. So which is the lowest number? 36, 39, 33, 42. So 33 is the lowest number. So 33 belongs to section C. So the lowest number of students is present in section C. Okay, so these were the questions which has been asked in your textbook. Okay, so what is your question? I repeat again, there are 4 sections of 3rd standard, and each section there are some number of students. Okay, section A has 36, section B has 39, section C has 33, and section D has 42 students. Okay, yes. So, and they've asked you 2 questions. Can you mention the section which has highest number of students? It is section D, because it is 42. Lowest number of students is section C, that is 33 is the lowest number. So section C has the lowest number of the students. And your next one is, you need to represent the given data in the form of a pictograph. As pictograph tells you that you need to express the information or give the information in the form of the pictures, right? So you need to give this 36 the pictures. You represent 36, 39, 33, 42 in the form of a pictures. And they have given you the key. What is a key? Key is you need to follow the smiley symbols. Okay. So, follow the smiley symbol. And one smiley symbol is 3 students. One smiley symbol is 3 students. Okay. So, one smiley symbol is 3 students. That means what? If I represent one smiley, it is 3 students. If I represent 2 smiley, that means it is 6 students. 3 plus 3, 6. If I represent 3 smileys, okay, it is 9 students. Okay, so like this you need to keep up. If I represent 4 smileys, 3, 6, 9, 12. So when I write 4 smileys, it is 12 students. Understood? Yes. Okay, now you need to represent 36 students in the form of smiley, 39 students in the form of a smiley and 33 students in the form of a smiley and 42 in the form of a smiley. How do you represent? I will tell you the simplest method. Okay. So, one smiley is 3 students. Fine. One smiley is 3 students. So, if you divide 36 and 3, whatever the answer you get, those are the number of smileys. Okay. Let me see. Let us divide. 36 is a section A. Divide 36 with the key. So, 1 smiley is equal to 3 students. So, when you divide 36 by 3, 3 ones are, 3 twos are. So, 3 twelves are 36. So, section A has 12 smileys. Okay. Section A has 12 smileys. So, how to write the smileys? See, you have number of students. Divide this number with 3. Okay, then you will get how many smileys to be drawn. So, when you, section A, 36 students, so divide 36 divided by 3. So, it is 12. So, when you represent 12 smileys, your strength is 36. Okay, let us represent 12 smileys. Okay, so, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 smileys you have represented. Okay. So to confirm, how correctly 12 smileys will come 36? You can confirm. So keep on adding. 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 3, 12, 12 plus 3, 15, 15 plus 3, 18, 18 plus 3, 21, 21 plus 3, 24, 24 plus 3, 27, 27 plus 3, 30, 30 plus 3, 33, 33 plus 3, 36. Okay, so now you came to know that what the problem we have done, it is correct. So, in an easy method, if you divide 36 and 3, you will come to know how many smileys to be written. Okay? Yes. Now, we will go for section B. What is our section B? 39 students. Okay? Our section B is 39 students. And what is our 1 smiley equal to? 1 smiley is equal to 3 students. So, divide by 3. Let's divide 39 by 3. So, 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. Okay. So, B is equal to 13 smileys. Okay. So, let's draw 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I have drawn small smileys. So, that's the reason it's taking a less space. Smileys. If you want to reach it, you can reach it. So, let us add. Each smiley is 3, right? 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 3, 12. 12 plus 3, 15. 15 plus 3, 18. 18 plus 3, 21. 21 plus 3, 24. 24 plus 3, 27. 27 plus 3, 30. 30 plus 3, 33. 33 plus 3, 36. 36 plus 3, 39. So, 13 smileys represent you 39. Okay? Yes. Hope you understood. Next, we will do for the C section. What is our C section strength? It is 33. So, let's divide 33 with our 1 smiley, that is 3. So, when you divide, you will get 3 elevens are 33. So, that means the C section has 11 smileys. So, let's do 11 smileys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so 33 students represents 11 smileys. Okay, yes, so this is the 33 students representing smiley. You can cross check, same we have done for the previous. And next, what is our D? D is 42. Our D section is okay, our D section is 42, so divide by 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 fours are 12. Okay, so the D section has 14 smileys. So let's draw 14 smileys. Okay, yes. So 1, 14 smileys, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay. Smileys represents the section D students. Okay, yes, so this is all about your today's recorded video. Okay, so we have solved your data handling, we have solved data handling pictograph lesson exercise 12A, the first one. Okay, so many kids have told they have not understood the pictograph for Moina ma'am, so she told me to explain once again the pictograph, all the sums. So in each video you will be getting the sums. Okay, you will be getting the answers for these sums. Those who have not understood, you can see this recorded video and can understand the concept in a better way. Okay, so whenever the online class is possible, I will be handling online classes. When I have class with grade 4, then I will be handling a recorded video. I will be sending you the recorded video. Okay, so this is all about today's class. Okay, yes, thank you children, hope you understood the concept exercise 12A first problem. Thank you and meet you in the next class. So this is the board, I'm just showing you what we have done here. Okay, exercise 12A first way, section ABCD students 36, 39, 33, 42, and each smiley is 3 students. So divide 36, 39, 33, 42 with 3. You will get answers like 12, 13, 11 and 14. So these are the numbers to be, smileys to be represented on the board. Okay. Yes. So this is all about today's class. Thank you. Meet you in the next class with next problem. Thank you.